So when the site is ready to go live, we want to connect a custom domain. Now, this can vary from client to client. It usually helps to figure out who the client's domain registrar is. This is where their domain is parked. Google Domains, GoDaddy, Namecheap, there are tools you can use to help you do this. Now, Hayes Valley is using Google Domains. Their domain registrar is Google Domains. We're going to log in to Google Domains with Rebecca's login, and in Domain Overview, we can see their current site. Now, while we're going to cover this for Hayes Valley, this can really vary. So we have a full article and separate video on connecting a custom domain on Webflow University. So check that out if you want some more clarity on this. We'll start by going to DNS, and that's it for now. Let's go back over to our project, and we can go up here to Project Settings, Hosting tab, and we'll want to make sure we've added a hosting plan. And once we've verified that, we can add our custom domain. And we'll just go to HayesValleyInteriorDesign.com. We'll hit Add Domain. Now, after you press that, there's a lot of information that will appear on the screen. That's okay. We're going to follow option one right here. We're going to add two-way records. And what we've done ahead of time is we've cleared out our resource records. You may have, for your client, a ton of resource records, and that's okay. But we can only have two resource records that are A records that point to a host, that point to a name of @. If you have other A records pointing elsewhere, that's okay, but you can only have two that are A records that point to a name of @. And what we'll do is we'll grab this first IP address and click it. That's going to copy it to our clipboard. Back to Google, we'll paste. That's the first one. The second one, we'll just press that little plus button. Go back, grab the second IP address, grab that second value, back over, and paste. We have both of those two A records that point to a name of @. We'll hit add. We're two-thirds done. Let's go back and grab our CNAME record. This is a CNAME record with a name of www and it points here. Let's copy that. We'll go and add CNAME, points to www, and add. So this is what we have on our screen now. Again, yours might look very different, especially if you're using a different registrar. We recommend taking a look at that full article before making any changes, and always back up these resource records. Take a screenshot, write them down, whatever you need to do before you modify any DNS records. Let's go back over to our hosting tab, and we'll hit check status. Check status. Now, it says issues detected. That's okay. Sometimes this can take a few moments before it goes through. And on first try, it says issues detected. It can take a moment for it to go through. We can press again, and now it says connected. Let's choose our default. We'll choose the www version as the default here. So from here, we can go back to the designer. We can do this from the dashboard, but we'll go back to the designer. We can take a look at our site. When we go down to publish, it's still on the staging domain. We can unpublish that, or we can uncheck that, so we're not publishing those changes there. But at any point, we can check here and publish to HayesValleyInteriorDesign.com. We're not going to right now. One quick consideration to make is that if we're switching from that staging domain, or we don't want that staging domain to be visible to search engines, we can go over to SEO and make sure that disable Webflow subdomain indexing is enabled. That's a fancy way of saying that Google and other search engines are going to be told not to look at, not to consider the information that's on this staging domain, hayesvalley.webflow.io. So whenever we're ready, we can go to publish and publish our site. But that's it. We've set the custom domain and we can now publish the site for the world to see.